from sea to shining sea. Yes, we can.
There is no one else in this race who can claim that kind of commitment to people on the ground. No
one. I've
had
the honor of doing that since I was 17 years old and entered the United States Naval Academy.
Don't tell me words don't matter.
Strongly support public financing.
I will sit down with John McCain and make sure that we have a system that works for everyone.
I promise that I will sit down with John McCain and talk about, can we preserve a public system?
Don't tell me words don't matter.
We've made the decision not to participate in the public financing system for the general election.
Now, it's doubtful that children reciting the Pledge of Allegiance are feeling pledged as a consequence of muttering the phrase, under God. I didn't. Most of the time when they're saying it, they don't even say all the words. You know, they're just kind of, it's all running into blah, blah, blah.
God bless America.
Whatever we once were, we are no longer a Christian nation.
And that our love stand beside her and guide her through the night.
I love America.
With a light.
Our souls are broken in this nation.
I will put my country first. Now and always, you can count on us.
To the prairies, to the oceans, white with foam.
Muttering the phrase, under God.
Change is coming.
Change and $1 trillion in new taxes over the next decade would certainly fit that description.
We have to compromise and sacrifice for one another in order to get things done.
I seek the presidency with the humility of a man who cannot forget that my country saved me.
We live in isolation, and because of that isolation, we fear one another.
We're the world's leaders. Leaders don't fear change, pine for the past, and dread the future.
Before we can work on the problems, we have to fix our souls. Our souls are broken in this nation.
There's never been a problem Americans couldn't solve.
Change and hope.
All these tax increases are under the fine print of the slogan, hope.
And hope.
They're going to raise your taxes by thousands of dollars a year, and they have audacity to hope you don't mind.
God bless America, my home, sweet home.
Don't tell me words don't matter.
I promise you, as President of the United States, I will always, always put my country first.
Restore the confidence of the American people in the future of this blessed and great country.
Don't tell me words don't matter.
Sacrifice for one another in order to get things done.
By allowing many of the current low tax rates to expire, they would impose overnight the largest single tax increase since the Second World War.
We don't know our neighbors. We don't talk. We believe that our pain is our own.
Senator Obama recently suggested that Americans are protectionists because they're bitter about being left behind in the global economy. Well, maybe that's his excuse for embracing the false promises of protectionism.
Words don't matter.
In 2008, we are still a nation that is too divided.
We look at it as them and they, as opposed to us. We don't,
and we are still a nation that is too cynical.
As if letting you keep your own earnings were an act of charity.
Don't tell me words don't matter.
God bless America. God damn America.
don't get sick in this country, not here.
I could go on and on and on, but this is how we're living, people, in 2008.
And things have gotten progressively worse throughout my lifetime.
From the mountains,
if we can't see ourselves in one another, we will never make those sacrifices. He is going to demand that you shed your cynicism, that you come out of your isolation, that you move out of your comfort zone. Push yourself to be better. Go back to your lives as usual. Uninvolved, uninformed. I am married to the only person in this race who has a chance of healing this nation.
America.
We will never, never, never surrender. Fight every moment of every day for what I believe is right for this country, and I will not yield.